Vaseline opens, House of Peace, to help us David start anew, Sandunga City, Sandunga Zeltzer, Philippines inside the sprawling camp of the Philippine Army's 4th Special Forces Battalion in Isabela City, Vaseline, stands a newly built one-story facility. There is nothing extraordinary about the building that houses an office, sleeping quarters and a prayer room, among others. But its name Beirut Salem, or House of Peace, makes it stand out in a land that has known violence and strife for decades. Inaugurated last week, the facility is dedicated to the reformation of former members of the Azud Desha, a group of bandits that has bedeviled Vaseline's growth and progress since its inception almost 30 years ago. The presence of the facility inside the army camp demonstrates how the military has been using a non-combat approach in dealing with the group, some factions of which have pledged allegiance to the Islamic State and laid siege on Morawi City in 2017. In previous years, Vaseline has endured massive military assaults to swash the Azud Desha, which has been behind high-profile crimes targeting both local and foreign victims. In neighboring Sulu, military operations continue against the group, as it has been linked to the bombing of the Solo Cathedral in January this year. Nerve Center Army Brig. Gen. Fernando Reyes, commander of Joint Task Force Vaseline, said the House of Peace will be the nerve center for the collaboration of the army, the Vaseline provincial government and Cagayan-based Ballet Mindanao in helping reform Azud Desha surrenderers. The operation of the new facility is part of the program against violent extremism, ACE, which was launched by the now defunct autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao, ARMS, and is now continued by the provincial government. Since 2016, the program has facilitated the surrender of some 214 former Azud Desha fighters who were driven to the hills by the thought that banditry would improve their social and economic lot. Many of them have been largely unschooled as they had joined the group when they were in their early teens. Underpaid beneficiaries are given assistance for livelihood, education and housing. They are also offered continuous values formation interventions. More than half of the Azud Desha surrenderers have enrolled in the Department of Education's Alternative Learning System, ALS, program. To date, 49 of them have successfully completed the 10-month schoolwork that qualified them for higher studies. The others opted for technical and vocational training and are now either employed or running their own small businesses using their newfound skills. The 300-square-meter House of Peace is run by Ballet Mindanao. According to Reyes, it will be used mainly for livelihood training sessions and personality development activities for the former bandits. Raya said he expected more Azud Desha members to turn their back on crime, as shown by the response of the communities in Vaseline to case. Likewise, he said some members may surrender after seeing how the lives of their former colleagues have changed for the better. Placed together, the facility will also serve as a halfway home for the former bandits before they are fully reintegrated into their respective communities, Raya said. Modong Indamit, a former Azud Desha subletter in Vaseline, said the opening of the House of Peace cemented their trust in the security forces and local government units in the province. "We now have a place together," said Indamit, citing the importance of exchanging views and experiences with fellow ex-combatants as they earn the ropes of a life outside banditry. Former ARM governor and now Vaseline Rep. Mujib Hadaman underscored the need for the government to win the trust of the people, especially the ABIS, and show that government will make a difference in their lives so that they will shun activities such as banditry. "The presence of government has to be felt by the people. We have to show them that government is sincere in providing basic services," Hadaman said. "These people would have not been in the jungle if there was a strong government here in the past," he said. "Vaseline is now enjoying relative peace," Hadaman said, "with hardly any report of military encounter in the mountains. We see growth in tourism and an increasing number of people visiting the province." Lieutenant Gen. Sir Alito Sobejana, Western Mindanao Command Chief, commended the accomplishments of the program in stemming radicalism and violent extremism in Vaseline. "We are harvesting the fruits of peace and these efforts should not only be attributed to the armed forces but to the local government units and the populace," Exodigen Effect. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.